not gonna lie, like 2 days before your period, it's just like, whoa! Yeah. It looks like you went, you know? Oh, hi.
My beautiful wife and I get to match.
And we get to talk about boobs. It's like all the best things in one video. So before we start talking about boobs, which is pretty much everybody's favorite topic to talk about, especially because, you know, the lesbian thing, this video is sponsored by Teamy or Tiami.
As we've been calling it the whole time.
Potato, potato.
Tomato, tomato.
Tiami, tomato.
More about Tiami at the end of the video and why I'm enjoying having them in my life.
Tell me about boobs. Do you think that lesbians are attracted to their own boobs?
I'm not gonna speak for every lesbian in the world, I'll speak for this lesbian, yes.
I like that your hand went, did you see where her hand
went?
Yes. It just completely
went. I wanted to touch them.
Cause just make sure they're still there?
No, cause I'm just glad that they're mine.
Ah! Me too!
About hers. I love my boobs and I'm definitely attracted to them.
Why do you love your boobs?
They're my ideal boob and okay. I get to just be like, oh, they're mine.
What makes them an ideal boob?
I know everybody has different preferences. It's not that I think mine are the perfect size, I just think they're the perfect size for me. It's nice to be able to just, you know, if I'm thinking, like just hold them.
If you have a thought in public, you're like, yes. 2 + 2 = 4.
So, you know, when you're just thinking.
In public?
Like, I have caught myself once or twice doing it, though. Maybe I have on a jacket or
You know when you see guys, like, adjusting themselves, you're always like, that's so gross. But if I saw a girl, like, doing that, I'd be like, that's so cool.
Maybe gay guys or people who are attracted to men are like, oh, you're adjusting yourself. Please adjust more.
Keep scratching there. That's gross.
I wouldn't say that.
It's so sexy.
How about you, babe? Are you attracted to your boobs?
Yeah, I am.
Why?
I just like the more boob in my life, the better. Like, I'm so fortunate to have boobs. The fact that now I'm also with somebody as a partner, like, I'm not with a guy, I'm with a girl who also has boobs. Like, that's 4 boobs. Like, that's so cool.
Uh-huh.
And like, sometimes they like to hang out with each other. Extra fun.
I think that your boobs are a source of confidence for you.
Mm.
They're very nice. I think that you're satisfied with the boobs that evolution gave you.
Evolution?
Yeah. You've had good boobs passed down, 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 and...
A way to make something sexy, not sexy. Also, I do want to talk about, like, whatever size boob that you have. I mean,
even if you don't have boobs.
Or if you have boobs and you don't like your boobs.
True.
What would you say to somebody who, like, is a lesbian who doesn't like their boobs?
Nothing wrong with that. And I think getting to a place of self-acceptance where maybe you don't have to love your body. You can accept it as it is. And if you're somebody who can't accept their body as there is, if you have dysphoria or something else, you don't have to. That's the great thing about living in today's world is you don't have to accept it. I used to not like my boobs.
You used to not like your boobs?
I remember because I was such a tomboy when I was younger.
Right?
When I first started getting boobs, say 5th grade or so, my mom and sister were like, maybe we should get you a sports bra. I started crying. I was devastated, unlike probably most girls who were thrilled. I thought immediately, you know, sports would be an issue.
Oh.
Horseback riding would be an issue.
Yeah.
I did not find my attractiveness or my self-worth based on my boobs. It was something that I started to appreciate not until much, much later in my 20s.
I like what somebody says here. Kate, if you don't like your own, you can always like someone else. That's good. That's such a
that's really good insight.
And you guys, we're live streaming on this site called DLive / Bri and Chris if you want to come watch us. Yeah, tell us about your boobs. We want to hear as much boob talk as possible. Thank you so much, Teamy, for sponsoring this video.
As y'all know, Bri and I both completed a 30-day detox. Bria was more going for losing a little bit of weight. And I was more going for just like cleaning out, getting a fresh start on my body. And
boy, did she clean out. I didn't go into that bathroom for a week.
Baby.
Sorry.
Don't
it was the best smelling. No, I'm sorry.
No, were cleaning out.
I was cleaning out too.
Disgusting.
Nobody went into that bathroom after either of us.
This is gross. That's not
You're gross.
Gross. Edit this out.
I will not.
Okay.
All right.
I did it more for just having a detox and getting a fresh start in with the new. I did not do the detox for weight loss purposes. And for anybody who is not trying to lose weight and is afraid of doing the detox because they will lose weight, I didn't lose weight doing the detox. And that's not why I did it. I did it to just do a cleanse and feel fresher. And I will tell y'all that while the first couple of days, say when it first started detoxing, I was like, I don't know if I'm gonna keep doing this. I don't like it. I would immediately feel, after the detox was done, I felt like more awake, cleaner. I felt like very energized, like a health and wellness boost. Mm-hmm. I felt like overall, I just felt better. I felt like my skin was doing better. I felt like I wasn't as bloated, yet I wasn't losing weight, which I did not want to. It's not like we stopped eating. We weren't starving during this detox. You ate as normal, and then drinking the tea helped you detox, and you keep moving forward with whatever your health goals are. Thank you, Teamy, for letting me have that experience. Baby girl had a very different one.
Thank you, Teamy, for letting Chrissy have that experience. I did have a very different experience, more as like concentrating on being mindful of what I put in my body.
I thought you were gonna say constipating.
Like every morning I would be drinking this tea, and every other night I was drinking the detox, and it really did help with being conscious of my calorie intake, made me more excited about working out, gave me more energy, and it did effectively cause me to lose some weight.
I'm slowly but surely accepting the fact that coffee is not helping with my anxiety. It doesn't help with my attitude. It doesn't help me to be more easygoing, and it makes my anxiety worse. Drinking just tea has really been a huge part of that, and the tea I've been drinking lately is Teamy.
And if you guys want to try Teamy, try the 30-day detox, all you gotta do is go to Teamy Blends. We'll put the link below, and we're giving you 15% off when you use the code BAC15. We will have it in the link below, BAC15 at TeamyBlends.com.
And in the comments below, how do you feel about your boobs? And also, is it Teamy or Teamy for you? We're on Team Teamy.
We love you guys. We will see you sometime soon. Big kiss,
big hug, big love, big boob love.
Big boob. Okay. One, two, titty.
Bye.